God bless you all. How about you, Brother Keith? Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Wow, wow, wow. Now, how did it turn out that you're all wearing the same shirt? Unbelievable. Oh, my goodness. Woo! Oh! What happened to the other attire? Oh, don't talk about that. Wow. Listen, this is a great day. Anybody out there? Yeah, this is a great day. To get this many people in a church on a Saturday morning, Pastor Phil, woo! You know, that's why we do breakfast first. Listen, we want to have a good time. We want to enjoy the Lord. We want to express the love of God that we have for each other. But know this. God does have something to say to us today. Amen?
Amen.
There is a depth inside every one of us that cries out for a God that we've never met yet. Can I get a witness? Ah, praise the Lord. We're going to introduce our speakers as they come up in a little bit. But first of all, to you all who have come, friends, family, God bless you all. God bless you all. Faces we haven't seen in a while. Folks who aren't even feeling that good, but you come anyway. Kathy. Yeah. And folks who aren't even able to come today because their bodies are a little broken. Is that all right?
Yeah.
You came for them. We love you. We're glad you're here. We want to honor some of the folks that are here with us today. And I'm going to start. I don't know why I'm starting with you, Pastor Steve. I say honor. I should be looking this way. No. I asked Pastor Steve to come because I it's the only chance I have to pick on him in a public forum. And I don't know why he puts up with it. Pastor Steve Kelly, you are a dear friend to me and to this house. So thank you for being here today. Last year, I think you said I usually cry, Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. Shout out the name of your church. Lehigh Acres Christian Church. God bless you and your church family. Thank you for honoring us today. We're going to call up Pastor Ray in just a moment. Pastor Ray is going to open us up with a word of prayer. Pastor Ray, we are honored to have you in the house, and to consider you a friend is also an honor. So God bless you. Pastor Ray. We're going to go down the line a little bit later on, but we have with us Dr. Randy Moore, who was here with us last night. God bless you, Dr. Randy Moore. Pastor Jennifer Williams, God has brought you to us, and we thank him for it. Pastor Jennifer Williams. Pastor Outlaw and your wife, Mrs. Outlaw, these folks are our neighbors. They are right down the road on Alabama, New Beginnings. How many have driven by their church? Amen. Yeah. Don't stop in. Don't stop in. But how many have driven by their church coming here? I drive by their church coming here every Sunday. Hallelujah! That's not right, because this brother back here is going to back up his pastor. Because I seen him moving towards me. Lord have mercy on us all this day. Everybody, the praise and worship team, hey. You guys look much better in those shirts, man. You guys look we love you. Everybody. Pastor Ray will come up and he's going to lead us in a word of prayer, if you will. Pastor Ray, today is a special day, everybody. Pastor Ray, would you lead us? Thank you. Yes, it is.
I love the t-shirts. It shows a unity.
Right.
I think that's important because that's what we're here for. We're all in unity with each other. Ephesians 2:19 tells us that we're no longer strangers and foreigners, but we're all citizens and members of the household of God. I think that's important for us to remember. Sometimes we can get bogged around the little details and the things that we disagree on and the things that we don't see the same on, but that's not important. The importance is that we're all members of the household of God.
Amen.
Jesus Christ died for each and every one of our sins, and that's important. Bow your heads. Father in heaven, we give you thanks for this day, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity to gather in your name. Father, your word tells us we are members of the household of God. And today we celebrate that and ask you to help set aside the things that cause division and disagreement. Father, we ask your Holy Spirit to pour out his presence and allow a clear line of communication to flow from the throne room of heaven into this group. Father, bless each and every person and group that is represented here today. Allow each of us to be filled with your word, and may we leave here filled to overfull. Father God, we all share the same bloodline, and today we ask that we remember that and show that godly beauty and sincerity to our brothers and sisters. We are gathered in your name and for your glory and honor. Have your way with each of us, and may we always feel your love in our lives. We love you and praise you, and ask this in the name of your precious Son, Jesus. And all of God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
All right, let me hear you out there. I need a 2 and 4 from you. There you go. You didn't know you were musical, did you, Brother Phil? But you are. Come now, it's time.
Come now, it's the time to worship. Come now, it's the time to give your heart. Come just as you want to worship. Come just as
I think you're awake yet. Let's sing that again. Come now, it's the time.
Come. Now is the time to worship. Come. Now is the time to give your heart. Come. Just as you want to worship. As you are before God.
All right, let's sing one day at a time. Come on now.
One day at a time we'll confess you are God. One day our knees will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly chose you.
Now one day at a time.
One day at a time we'll confess you are God.
Sing that with just the drums.
One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you.
Now one day every tongue.
One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those.
Just as you are
to worship.
you, Lord, that you're mighty to save for all of us.
Everyone needs compassion, love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior.
Sing that again. Everyone needs compassion.
Everyone needs compassion. Love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness. The kindness of the Savior. Everything I believe in,
I surrender.
Now I surrender.
Yes,
I surrender.
Thank you, Lord. Just give him a hand clap. Thank you, God, that you conquered. Sing this beautiful old hymn together.
And I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene.
One.
And one
blessing.
He took my sin and my sorrow.
Oh, that should make you happy now.
He made them his very own.
He bore the burden.
Stay in an attitude of prayer just for a moment, everybody. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord, we acknowledge this day. We know, my Lord God, that you planned this day a long time ago. And I know you planned to bring all of your children together, your sons and your daughters together in this house. We thank you for it. And the house isn't a new image. The house is God's house. It's wherever we meet. It's God's house. God's house. It's the people. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You said, Lord, that the name of this weekend is deeper, and we believe it, Lord, and this is our heart. We say, my Lord, as the ministers come forward and they give us the word that you have whispered within their ears, you have whispered within their ears words of light and life, and I know that you have told them to come and give us the words of God. We ask as they speak your words from heaven that it would be the light from heaven that will penetrate the depths of everyone inside this house today, we pray. And I pray, my Lord God, let something be illuminated that we never knew was there. I pray that we find some strength. I pray that we find a life. I pray that we find a new identity, who we really are and who we've always been. We thank you for your precious, powerful word. We thank you for loving us. We thank you for all of that you're doing in this weekend. It's in your wonderful name we pray. Everybody says, amen. Amen. You may be seated. God bless you all. Amen. 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 Praise and worship team, God bless you all. Mm-hmm. That music is so beautiful. Amen. It is so beautiful. As the weekend goes on, I want you to know, by no means do we overlook what you all have done for us and are doing for us. This music is extraordinary. I believe it's the sound of heaven. Amen? Amen. Our first speaker today, allow me a minute or two to introduce, is our Dr. Randy Moore. And many of you may know Dr. Randy Moore. He's been to this house. Come on, Dr. Randy, come on. I'll let everybody look at you as we talk about you. Oh, this man is a great man. This man is a great man. We are honored to have this man in this house. Now, he goes everywhere. He's an evangelist, I guess. Is that right? And he goes everywhere, and he'll fill the gap wherever the gap may be. So thank you for coming today.
Thank you.
And let me say this. When I see you, I think of my father. My father as the father of this house, but I think of you as the age, the one filled with wisdom and grace and sensitivity, and you hold the family together with your words of just pure grace, Randy. So thank you for being here. God bless you, sir. Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much. Let's give the Lord a good hand. How about it? Praise God. Everybody say deeper. That's where we're headed. How about you?
All right.
I've made my mind up. I read in Psalms, David said, deep calls to the deep. Amen. So there's something out there deeper than what I've found. Amen. And it's calling me. It's calling you. And I'm not going to let nobody stop me from finding what this is. No matter how deep it takes me, I'm going. So I want you to do me a favor, nobody here but us. And let me first say I thank your pastors for having us here today. And what a fine gentleman Brother Mike is. There's something about that man. Just really appreciate you. Amen. And we appreciate you so much for your hospitality and all the love and fellowship that you've shown, Pastor Mike. Now, look at somebody and say, stay out of my way. I'm going to go deeper. So just don't get in my way. Praise God. Somebody say, praise God. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to dig and get deeper and see what there is down there and what there is down in here.
All right.
Amen. How many enjoyed that message that Phil gave last night?
Praise the Lord.
Fantastic. Great job. Great job last night. If you've got your Bibles, turn with me to Isaiah chapter 45. Isaiah chapter 45. I want to begin with verse 2. I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. I will give thee the treasures of darkness. Everybody read that part. I will give thee the treasures of darkness. Say that out loud.
I will give thee the treasures of darkness.
I will give thee the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of secret places, that thou mayest know that I, the Lord, which call thee by thy name, am the God of Israel. Amen. Verse 6, that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. Praise God. Now we're going to Galatians chapter 5. Chapter 5, we're going to begin with verse 13. For brethren, you have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, that thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. And if you bite and devour one another, take heed ye be not consumed one of another. Take heed that you be not consumed one of another. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary one to the other, so you cannot do the things that you would. But if you be led of the Spirit, you're not under the law. Division. Now, isn't this amazing? We call ourselves a Christian nation. And yet this church refuses to have fellowship with this church over here. Because there may be one or two little things that you disagree on. And so therefore we cannot go on, we cannot go any deeper, because that church over there, that pastor over there, does not agree and believe like I do, so therefore I can't go on with God. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I found out a long time ago, if I don't dwell on what him and I cannot agree on, but if I can dwell on what we do agree on, I can fellowship with almost anybody.
Very good. All right.
How about you?
Yeah. Yes.
There's fellowship amongst the body of Christ if we want it bad enough. What deeper? We talk about deeper, and this is a strange thing, talking about deeper. When Pastor Mike said, our theme is deeper, right away I thought, deeper what? I mean, you don't hear that too much anymore. Deeper? Does that mean, just tell me what that means. And yet, deeper is transition. Deeper means you just keep walking into experiences and revelation and truth that you haven't been to yet. It's all a walk. Now, somebody says you've got to be careful not to forget where you came from. Well, I remember where I came from, but that doesn't mean that I can't go on and that I have to stay in this one place. I'll never forget where I came from, because that was the beginning of the deep calling to the deep. That was the open door. I had to start someplace, and when the Holy Spirit spoke to my heart and said, you need a Savior, I realized how badly I needed one. And that was the beginning of my transition. In a little Baptist church down in the dark hills of West Virginia, in the Appalachian, I came from a family of alcoholics. Not only were they alcoholics, but they were starving. You see how big I got. It's all due on the Appalachian Mountains. It's all their fault. But anyhow, my family was a messed up family. I mean, really messed up. My dad was an alcoholic. I had sisters, alcoholics, brothers, alcoholics. But I didn't want to be one. I did not want to do what they were doing. And yet I didn't know the ways of God. I didn't know any other way. And a little Baptist preacher came to me and says, Randy, I think you need to go to church with me. All this time, there was something going on inside of my heart. I knew, Pastor, there had to be something more than this. Alcoholism is not the answer. And I thought, there's got to be a way out of this, but I don't know the way out. And there, I found the Lord Jesus Christ. For just a moment, he filled my soul, and for a moment, he satisfied my need. Thank God for satisfaction of salvation. That started my transition. And so, as I gave my heart to Jesus, I began to find out some more things. Now, I was gloriously born again in that church, the little Baptist church. Right around the railroad tracks, there was a Pentecostal church. That should never have been, because they were all of the devil. Anyhow, some of the people came to me and says, Randy, you need to visit us. I said, how can I visit you? You got something that we're not supposed to mess around with. You don't mess around with speaking with tongues and the gifts. You just stay away from that. It's poison. I heard New Image was poison. And here I am partaking of poison. A glutton for punishment. The deep calls to the deep. Oh, y'all are quiet. Anyhow, they begin talking about this new experience. And one day I slipped in and visited that little church. And they were doing things I would never have dreamed of doing. Absolutely not. I'm a Baptist, and once a Baptist, you're always a Baptist, no matter right or wrong. Good or bad, ugly or sweet, it doesn't matter. How many know what I'm talking about? I thought you did. But anyhow, after a while, something began to get a hold of me. I'm watching and I'm looking and I'm seeing things I've never seen. I've tasted the good word of God. I'm saved. I'm washed in the blood of Jesus. But they've got something I don't have. And so once again, the deep begins to call to the deep. There's something more. Randy Moore, there's something more. But what else is there other than salvation? What can there be? And someone said, you need to be filled with the Spirit. I thought I got that when I got saved. Well, you did, but there's more. How can there be more? Well, just come and visit us again. And I did. And pretty soon there was something drawing me. And I was open to it. I wanted more than what I had. Even though this was satisfying up to a point, there had to be more. There's something inside of me telling me that there's wells of water that wants to spring out of me, but I've got it all dammed up and clogged up with tradition. And if I would just reach out and receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, then this well inside of me will be released and it can flow freely. And so guess what? I opened up and I received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And it flowed out of me. It poured out of me. I had something. I'm sure I had it all. I thought. And yet the more that I read from God's Word, it's telling me there's more. It's telling me there are secrets in dark places. It's telling me there are riches that hasn't been tapped into yet. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I've tasted a lot of good things and I've drunk from deep wells. And I've been blessed, and I know from Ephesians chapter 1 all that I am in Christ up to a point. And I could go there and begin to read all of that, and it's so good, but time fails me to go into all of that. But somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
But just for a moment. In Ephesians chapter 1, just for a moment. It starts out with verse 2. It says grace. Everybody say grace.
Grace.
That's the deepness of God. Only God's grace can bring you into a depth like this. Grace and peace. Peace. You can be saved and have no peace. Turmoil. Grace and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings. All spiritual blessings. There's not one thing out there that He's going to withhold from us if we'll just get a little bit hungry and begin to reach for it. He's saying, I've got it. Do you want it?
That's right.
Well, but I might be called poison. Somebody might not like me and what I stand for. Somebody might think I'm in false doctrine. Somebody might get upset with me. Well, who cares? They're upset with you anyhow. For you know in the Lord they're upset with you. So let them get upset. Maybe they'll get hungry. Maybe the deep will begin to call to the deep if they get upset bad enough. So I say, oh God, upset them. Let them get really upset. They say you're supposed to be dignified. Verse 4. He's chosen us. I didn't know He chose me. I'm transcending from one step, from one experience, from one glorious thing to another. And now I find out that I'm chosen. He chose me. From the foundation of the world. God chose me before He ever formed the world. How could He possibly do that? How could God say, Randy Moore, I choose you, and there's not even a star yet? I choose Randy Moore, and there's not even a whale yet. And yet from the foundation of the world, God chose Thomas Houlihan. Amen. Somebody say praise God. Verse 5. Heaven predestinated us. I'm predestinated. So I have gone from one glory to another glory. I've gone from one faith to another faith. And yet I find that there's no end to this thing. They're talking about the bottomless pit. In God, there is no bottom. The more that you find, the deeper you go, you're going to find more depth, and you're going to go deeper and deeper. And this is the theme of this conference, deeper, deeper, deeper in the love of Jesus. I don't know how deep we can go, but here I am, God. Take me like a submarine. Take me downward. Down to the depths. And there in the depths of it all, let me find all of God, that I might be like Him in His fullness. Let me be what He wants me to be. How many wants more of God? Can you say with me one more time, deeper?
Deeper.
Not so, don't break the ribs. Just nudge just a little bit. And look at him and mean it. Look at him seriously. I'm going to go deeper.
Going to go deeper.
So stay out of my way.
Stay out of my way, Bill.
Deeper.
Deeper.
Would you stand? Now just reach over as a point of contact and take somebody by the hand. Dear Father, we come into Your holy divine presence.
Praise the Lord. Yes, Lord.
And we thank You because You're here.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
You're in us.
Praise Your Lord.
And You're sitting upon the well of our hearts.
Amen.
And now, Father, we open our hearts to You that rivers of water may run out.
Hallelujah.
And I pray, Lord, that I will be an open well.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
That I will be an artesian well.
Praise you, Lord Jesus.
That the waters of life and the waters of revelation,
yes,
and the waters of your mystery,
yes,
may flow forth from
Lord.
My life.
Yes,
and let every person
Praise
that's gathered
Lord.
Here this morning,
yes,
let these wells spring
Praise
up. Spring up into everlasting life. Touch every heart.
Hallelujah.
Fill every soul.
Hallelujah.
Satisfy every hunger
Praise
of every
Lord
heart.
Jesus.
I pray this in the mighty name
Hallelujah.
Of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise
amen.
Praise
amen.
You, Lord.
Amen.
Praise
and amen.
Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Keep going, folks. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word and your faithful servant. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Dr. Randy. I know you say it's just Randy. I know. Dr. Randy. Dr. Randy, you wowed me today, brother. You wowed me. Anybody else? Woo! Now, there's a lot of excitement, and enjoy all the excitement, but we hear the words of God. We hear the words of God. I hear the word of God. The bottomless pit. And it's God. Who? It's God. Amen. Oh, Pastor Phil? Wow. Our next speaker, and before, just give me one moment before I introduce our next speaker. We have Pastor Tommy Hollihan with us. And Pastor, God bless you. A good friend, and all the way from Cape Coral, but even as we've known you in a short period of time, it seems like we've known you for a long period of time. I don't know, it just seems that way. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but it's a New York thing. All joking aside, although I like the joking, we're honored to have you. Thank you. And for bringing the men with you. Thank you. Mm-hmm. God bless you. Mm-hmm. Okay. It's too late. Now, if you'll allow me, I want to introduce our next speaker. And Pastor Outlaw, would you stand up here next to me as I introduce you? Would you give our brother a hand? Pastor Outlaw is a new friend. I like it because God does new things and old things. You're a new friend, and we're honored by your friendship. First and foremost, we're honored by your friendship. That's the biggest thing of all. And to have you and your church here and your church people here, we're honored that you're here, brother. Thank you. And aside from his friendship, he's a man of God, and I know he talks to God. I know God talks to him. So I just want him to give him the liberty as he brings forth the word of God. Amen, everybody? Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. No, really, give him praise. Come on, give the Lord some praise in the house. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and just wave at him just for a moment and tell him thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, wave at the Lord and tell him thank you. Somebody may come here today that wasn't feeling well, but you were able to get up this morning and come into the house of the Lord. Tell him thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Glory to God. It is truly a privilege, an honor, and a blessing to be here today. Truly want to give thanks to the Lord God, our Savior, and to his servant, Michael Porzio,
Amen.
The pastor of this great church, and the leadership. Praise God. All the leadership staff. It is truly a blessing to be here today. I just want to say I thank God for the wisdom of Pastor Mike to look out into the congregation of God, the different churches, and bring us together today on this great occasion. When I spoke to him, he said the theme is deeper. And so I'm studying 1 Corinthians 2, and he says the theme is deeper. But what I want to hear from you is where God have you, amen. Where he's taking you, what he's saying to you. All right, what is he saying to you for the body of Christ, amen. Where you are serving? And I want all pastors to hear that. We are serving. Amen. We should be serving God's people. Amen. Serving. Not demanding, but serving. Amen. And that's why I say it is such wisdom that he would not only want to hear what God is saying to him, but what is God saying to the rest of us? And you are such a blessed people to be under his leadership. Because he not just look at what God is giving him, but he looks out into the community and into the body of Christ and gather men and women around him to say, what is God saying to you? And he said, now let's gather at the house that God has appointed me and let the folks that God have given me to care for hear what is being said in the church. I pray you hear that. It's not just the voice of a man, but the voice of God as he speaks to the body of Christ, uniting us into one place of his glory. And so since he said that, I want to hear what God is saying to you. Well, the theme that we are under right now is setting the atmosphere for the presence of the Lord. Setting the atmosphere for the presence of the Lord. And under that theme, there's a topic that we also have, and that is entering into God's rest. Setting the atmosphere for the presence of the Lord and entering into God's rest. Setting the atmosphere is something that we started months ago, and it's just that. I need you to understand, you have to set an atmosphere. You have to set. Just like you set the dial to the station that you want to hear on your radio, you have to set the atmosphere. Once you realize that Christ has come to live and dwell in you, you have to set the dial on who you will hear, who you will hear from, who you will believe, and who you will receive. You can't just receive everything everybody's saying because no one knows the truth like God can reveal it to you. Amen. It doesn't matter what you're experiencing if you set the dial to Jesus. If you set the dial to the Holy Ghost, if you set the dial to God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost for your life, you can only set the dial for your life. And you can share that with other people. The atmosphere must be created within you. Who will you serve? Who is God to you? Amen? Amen. So setting the atmosphere, when we first looked at that, I went to Genesis 4 and verse 4. Amen? Amen. So I want to ask you to turn there with me real quickly. Genesis 4, verse 4. And this is where Abel and Cain brought their fruit unto the Lord. Just want to see, give you a picture of what setting the atmosphere would look like in the scripture. Verse 4 said, and Abel, he also brought of the firstling of his flock and the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and his offering. Amen? Yeah. I want you to look at this. And Abel also brought of the firstling. We have to give God first, not partake of what we want to choose from what God has given us. It shows that I realize and recognize that I would have nothing had God not blessed me with what he blessed me with. And so since I'm so keenly aware that it is God, I'll set the atmosphere not for myself, but for God. I show that I know and realize and recognize that it is God that gives increase. It is God that has given me these blessings. It is God who teaches me how to get wealth. And through his method and ways, I'll make him first. So he gave to him the first of the flock and the fat thereof, meaning the very best. The very best that God gave him, he didn't take it and save it for himself. He gave it unto the Lord. Are you giving God your very best? Are you really giving God your very best? Is a question. Amen? That only you can answer. Let me tell you what the very best that you can give God. Your heart.
Very good. Amen.
Not your substance.
Right, right.
You see, the difference between Cain and Abel is that Abel gave God his heart and his soul, his mind, his will.
Right.
He gave it to God.
Right.
And that's why his mind was so fixed on putting God first, because he recognized that it is God who deserves the best. Amen? And just notice in verse 5, but unto Cain and his offering, God had no respect. God says, I can't receive anything that's less than what I've given you. Please hear me. God has given you today the very best through his son, Jesus Christ.
Right.
Guess what God is looking for in return? His son. When Pastor Randy was speaking deeper, the deep is crying out to the deep. God is not crying out to me. He's crying out to him within me. God is crying out to that place that only he can satisfy. The place that only he can truly occupy. He's calling out to him in me. And let us make man in our image doesn't mean that he made us to look like him in appearance, but it means that he gave us the character, the attributes of God, that no other of God's creation has what you have as a man. You have a right to choose. You have a faculty within inside of you that you can make choices. Think about it. Animals do what animals do. Trees do what trees do. You don't have to beg a tree to serve and praise and worship God. It automatically reaches up its branches towards heaven to acknowledge God.
Amen.
It automatically, its roots grow deep into what it's planted in. But man, because he has a choice, you have to set the atmosphere. God put us in a place and a position within himself, and we chose not to stay there. But that's the difference between man and any other of God's creation. But please, don't be discouraged. The Holy Ghost has now come, and he will take you deeper. He will lead you and me and guide you and I into a deepness with God. Amen?
Amen.
A place that we can know otherwise dwell in, except that God lives in you and I. Amen?
Yes.
And we have to choose to allow him to do this. Amen? Amen. Psalms 91. It reads, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, who will say of the Lord? I will say of the Lord. It's what you say of the Lord. Who is he to you? The psalmist say, I will say of the Lord. It's not that I will say of my circumstances. I won't speak of my situation or my condition or my issues or my. That's where you find yourself in trouble. My. But it's, I will speak of the Lord. What will you speak of the Lord? He is my refuge. Why would you say that God is my refuge? If I am here to say that God is my refuge, I must not be experiencing a place of rest. To draw me to the conclusion that my rest is not, or my place is not in what I'm experiencing, but my place is in the knowledge of who, knowing who God is for my life. I will say of the Lord, who he is my refuge, my place of safety, my dwelling place, the place that I go into and find rest. He is my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Listen, let's make sure that we know that we are the ones in charge. It is up to you how you will set the dial for your life. Having the Holy Ghost, having the Spirit of God, you still must make a conscious decision to allow him to have his way in and through your life. When you ask Jesus to come in, I pray to God that we come to know that when he comes in, it is because it is for the purpose of us now stop following our way. Jesus said, if any man will come after me, the first thing he must do is to deny himself. If you will be like me, if you will exemplify the authority and allow my authority to work in and through your life, as you see me operate, you must deny yourself. Jesus did not come into the world to do his own thing. He came into this world to do the will of the Father. And he's saying to you and I that we cannot live in this life, in this world, and expect God's results without applying Christ to our life. The methods in which he chose when he, being God, said, I do not speak the things of my own, but that which my Father gives me. We have to be careful what we're saying. We're saying what we're seeing, and we're having what we're saying. Death and life is in the power of your tongue. Be careful what you say. That is not to say that there's not sickness in my body, but don't dare leave it there. You also have the Holy Spirit living in you. So cover that sickness with the presence of God, with the power of God, and don't just leave it floating around out there. The theme is setting the atmosphere. Under the theme, we have entering into God's rest. Entering into God's rest will come from Hebrews 4. Hebrews 4, turn with me real quickly. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hebrews 4. I take this entering God's rest from verse 8 through 11. For if Joshua had given them rest, then he would not afterwards have spoken of another day. There remains therefore a rest for the people of God. For he who has entered into his, God's rest, has himself also ceased from his own works as God did from his. Let us therefore be diligent to enter into that rest, lest any man fall according to the same example of disobedience. Amen. It is disobedience that always got us into trouble. God told Adam and Eve not to eat of the fruit. What did they do? They ate of the fruit. It's always when we do what God tells us not to do that gets us in trouble. It's always when we do what God tells us not to that gets us in trouble. When we do what God tells us to do, we will not find ourselves in trouble. When we do what God tells us to and trouble comes, we will still have rest because God commands that we worship him and put him first. If God is first, then he's more than sickness, disease, worry, and fear. If we understand what God is saying and receive it, what God is saying and apply it to my life, what God is saying, we'll have what God is saying. Amen. You will have whatsoever you say, but what you say is what you believe. If you believe God, you will speak of God in his way. I can say I trust God, but I'm in fear of what this sickness is going to do to me. To know God is to trust God.
Amen.
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 So I look at this season that we've entered into, and even the trees know to rest. I mean, you notice that we're going into the fall season, winter, spring, summer, and fall. And isn't it amazing that the trees know? It's starting to lose their leaves, and they've toiled all summer. They've done their hard work, and God is calling the trees to rest. And so they lose their leaves. I know we live in Florida, so we probably don't know a whole lot about trees losing their leaves. But you know, if you travel anywhere up the road, any little distance there, like right North Florida or Georgia, then you see how many of the trees, you look out there and they done lost their leaves. Amen. They're resting. Isn't it amazing that even the trees worship God? He designed them and created them to lose their leaves during this time of year. Amen?
Yeah, amen.
And the sap begins to fall, and the tree begins to rest. But man is still busy. The only way to enter into God's rest is to cease from your own works. And we're working really hard and still not accomplishing the things that we're working so hard for. But the tree knows, and the grass knows to rest. Even the crops know to rest. Even the bears know to hibernate and to rest. Animals know to rest and don't have that mind like God has given us. They know to rest. And yet man, who has a mind to think, don't know how to rest. I need you to understand, rest don't come from sleep. Rest comes from knowing who God is.
Good. All right.
And trusting God.
All right. Amen.
Amen?
Yes.
Rest is a state of peaceful unity with God. Now watch this. How can you have a state of peaceful unity with God if you don't have a state of peaceful unity with your brethren?
Uh-huh.
A state of peaceful unity.
Uh-huh.
That means not looking at your brother, even if you find fault, you don't find fault. Even if you see something to grumble and complain about, you don't make mention of it. Let me tell you why. You enter into rest when you won't speak what is seen in the natural. You enter rest when you're in the spirit, in the presence of the Lord.
Excellent. Very good.
Because God has seen more faults in me than I can ever see in you.
All right, all right.
And he don't talk to me. He don't come
Thank
to me
Lord
talking
Jesus.
To me about
Amen.
My faults.
Thank you, Lord.
He comes to me and he shares his grace, his mercy, and his truth.
Thank you, Lord.
And it is through that grace, mercy,
Amen.
And truth
yes.
that I discover yes. God.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Christ in me and Christ in you
Amen.
Is the hope of overcoming
Amen.
All these challenges that you and I are facing. But we must understand, just like the tree, the reason it loses its leaves is because the sap in the tree begins to fall. Amen? And it loses its substance. Wonder how the tree make it through that cold, bitter winter, and it's lost its substance because God takes care of the tree when it's naked. Some of us won't get naked in front of God. Let me break that on down so we can make sure we get that one. You have to come before God realizing that God is God and you're not.
Good. Right.
You have to let yourself know that you are not in charge. You don't know what God knows. God has a plan and a future that you don't know nothing
That's
about
right. That's right.
until you get deep in God.
Yeah.
Then he begins to show you and me him
The Lord.
And his plan. even through the tests, the trials and tribulation, it's just to test me to see if I know who my God is. It's just to test you to see what you will say while you're going through. Will you praise God? Will you worship God? Will you acknowledge him? Will you magnify the Lord now? How can we sing the songs of Zion in a strange land? Well, you can sing the songs of Zion while your body is in a strange land if your heart was still fixed on God.
Praise your Lord.
Because there were those who were able to.
That's right.
Amen?
Yes.
You can't set the dial for no one but you. Amen?
Amen.
But you must make a decision whether or not you will set it for yourself. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. I'm getting ready to try to close this. And so with that being said, I want to sandwich deeper. I want to sandwich deeper between setting the atmosphere and entering into God's rest. We're going to go deeper now.
All right.
You set the atmosphere. We entered into his rest. And now it's time to go deeper. I like to look at this as it's like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Amen? You get two slices of bread, and you put peanut butter on one side, and you put jelly on the other side. And then when you put them two good things together, yeah. Wow.
Yeah,
amazing.
All right.
How they both right. taste so much better yeah. than either one of them. Good. Oh, y'all better hear what I'm saying. Than any one of them apart.
All right, yes.
So I'm going to take setting the atmosphere and entering into his rest, and I'm going to put deeper in between.
All right.
And when they come together, it's deeper. There's a deeper flavor. There's a deeper mixture. Amen?
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 Yes, amen.
Praise God. So let's turn over here to this wonderful, wonderful, powerful scripture. 1 Corinthians 2. Amen. But as it is written, eye has not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who
love him.
For those who
love him.
For those who not say they love him. Because a lot of times we say we love God. Amen?
Yes.
But when we love him, we will see better. Amen?
Yeah.
If I told my wife I love her and never come home and spend time with her, you think she'd believe that? If we love God, we'll spend time with him. How do you get to know a person? You got to spend time with them. They got to see you when you're going through your good times. They got to be there when you're going through your bad time. They got to be there. They need to be there when you're going through whatever time. And that's how you really get to know somebody. Amen?
Amen.
If you haven't been there in my tough time, you don't know me yet.
All right.
I mean, you know that you don't get to know your sisters and brothers just because you see them in church on Sunday. You have to spend some time together. You got to know all their faults and still, and then see if you love them now. Did you know that they were talking about you just the other day and not in such a good way?
Uh-huh.
Did you hear what they said about you?
Yep.
Huh? You ought to hear what they said.
Yeah.
That shouldn't affect you to the point and place to where you go and try to defend yourself. Because if you do, that means you don't know who you are.
All right.
Amen. Eyes have not seen, nor have ears heard. Eyes didn't see, nor have ears heard, nor have entered into the heart of man, the heart of man, the heart of man. The things which God has prepared for those who love him. But God has revealed, I love that, God has. How many of you waiting on God to reveal it to you? The word here says God. The conflict is whether or not I will spend time with God to see what God has done. Not what God's going to do. That's why every experience is an experience unto God. Every test and trial and tribulation is not a problem, it's an opportunity. We must begin to see the challenges in our lives more as an opportunity than a problem, a challenge, or an issue, because it's only testing you to see if you know who you are in Christ, or even if you are in Christ. It's challenging you to see if you truly depend on this God you say you know. Amen? So we really need to get to know him. But God has revealed him unto us through his, and it's capitalized, spirit. Not my spirit, but his spirit. For the spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. Amen. Paul's point is that humans cannot begin to comprehend what God has prepared for those who love him. The future blessings that believers enjoy here and for eternity are beyond the human understanding. Amen? It's beyond the human understanding. Only God, as we go deeper by his spirit, can reveal to us the truths of our experience in life. As Dr. Randy said earlier, he predestined me. If he predestined me before, I'm pretty sure he can take care of me while I'm here. If my understanding and thinking of God becomes deeper, then I won't have the fears that I've been having in the past because of the situation and experiences that I've had, that I'm having today. If I look back over my life when I was a sinner and God took care of me, how much more today is he going to take care of me as I draw closer to him? Amen? Yes, somebody, come on, give the Lord a praise right there. We need to know the truth, because it is the truth that will make us free. And we can rest. Amen? We can rest as we continue to set the atmosphere. It's only what God says. It's not about what anybody else say. It's not about what's going on in the earth. It's not about ISIS, whoever they are. It's not about Ebola, whoever he is. Amen? It's about God. If you hear these names and it causes fear to be struck within you, it's because you don't know the name that's greater than every name. Now, I say this so that each man will examine himself. To test yourself, not to test those around you, to see if you know the truth. Because those that know the truth will make you free. It will create within you a freedom that no matter what happens, I win. No matter what happens, if I stick with God, I win. Amen.
Amen.
Just like mustard and mayonnaise on two slices of bread. Deeper is the meat between setting the atmosphere and entering into his presence. Between both of those is the meat to go deeper, to go deeper into the Lord. God bless you.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I wanted you to stand with me as we pray. Now, Father God, as we have received
yes, Lord.
This bread,
yes, Lord.
This meat from your table, I pray now, Father, in the name of Jesus, that it be received into our hearts, our mind, our soul, and our will, that it be carried out within our lives, Lord God, that we realize that we are the ones who make the decision whether or not we receive your word of truth, your presence, and your word, Father God, in our lives. It is left up to us, and I pray in the name of Jesus, Father God, that we receive today your word of life and truth. And Father God, as we are now in a season where even the earth is entering into the place of rest, I say and pray for this people, your people, to begin to enter into your rest, Lord God, to stop toiling with one another and even within ourselves, to trust and know that you are God and you're in charge. You're gonna see us through just like you have before. Father God, we thank you and we praise you for this glorious occasion whereby you have brought us together to be assembled together in your presence as a family of God. Today, we thank you and we give you praise right here and right now in the name of Jesus. As you take us together, Father God, not separated, but together as a family of God, when the congregations and the churches can come together, we will find a deepness in who you are. Father, we thank you again for Pastor Mike and his team of staff, Father God, who put this weekend together. We magnify and glorify you through in and through their lives. And may this house be continuously blessed with the power of your presence. In Jesus' name, we give thanks. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
You may be seated, everybody. Praise the Lord. Don't go nowhere. Don't go nowhere. Praise the Lord. This is what I have to say. Sometimes when you hear these words, when I'm sitting there, this is what I'm thinking. How am I going to remember all that? You know, I should be taking notes, or I got to listen to it again. And yes, that's all true. You know, see, Brother Keith, I believe, and these things are on Facebook. We have CDs. I believe you have to listen to them again. But the most important thing is not how am I going to remember everything he just said. I want to come up and I want to repeat everything he just said. Well, that's not it either, though. But I believe this, and we've said it before. The words that were spoken, they have changed you forever. It's mission accomplished. The eternal words of God, they have gone inside of me. They have changed me. The word does the work. I don't. By hearing the words of God, we have been changed forever. And I know that God, in his own time, in his own place, will cause those words even to come alive in our lives as we walk this. You know that? I believe it. I believe it. I believe words will come to our spirit. I believe it will change the way we talk and respond. And because you can't remember all these words. They're great words. And I'm going to end with this one thing. You know, we do bring in visitors, and they do come in, and they do powerful things. But as we do bring in our visitors, I say always this: do not forget the locals that we have, because Jesus said a prophet is without honor in his own town. And I say, let that not be said of us. Let us see the power of God that is, forgive me, right down the road. Amen. God bless you. Now, I want to introduce our next speaker, and I'm going to ask our pastor, Jennifer Williams, will you come up and stand with me while we introduce you? Amen. Pastor Jennifer Williams. Pastor Williams, of course, we're blessed to have you here, and I know that God has knit our hearts together for great purposes. When I see Pastor Williams, I see a woman who is filled with love, pure love. And she teaches me that love, by the way. Sometimes we've got to be taught how to love. She teaches me how to love. I see compassion for people. And the transparency and the power of that. We're honored to have you in this house. Why don't you teach us? Teach us how to love. Amen. Everybody, Pastor Williams. Amen. Thank you.
Bless the Lord, everybody. Praise God, everybody. Bless you, Lord. I honor you, Jesus. You're awesome, God. You're so great. You are wonderful. Father God, whatever you said to do, God, I'm going to do it.
Amen.
Whoever you leads, God,
amen.
I'm going to follow you. I'm going to follow you all the way, Lord, because I'm going to worship you. I'm going to worship you, Lord. I'm going to magnify your name, Jesus, for you are great. Hallelujah. Oh, God, you are awesome, Lord, and you are good. There is none like you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I bless you all this wonderful, awesome day that the Lord has made, and we are here to rejoice. We are here to give him thanks, to give him glory. Hallelujah. For the deeper that is about to explode on the inside. Hallelujah. Of each and every person. Praise God. I greet you, Senior Pastor. Praise God. Bless you. Pastor Phil, glory to God. Pastor Michael, and all the pastors in the house. Doctor, praise God. Pastor Outlaw, I honor God. Because this is not by any chances. Thank you so much. Praise God. Thank you. Thank you, God. Bless you. Amen. Bless him, Lord. Bless him some more. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. When I was asked to come to you guys with this word, my soul right then received. And I said, ouch, God. As the Lord was dealing with me, I'm like, ouch, God. But I realized that with God, all things are possible. For all, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. What the Lord wants us to really get, how to get deeper. I bless the Lord for the speaker that go before. I thank God that they went before. Lord of mercy. Woo! God is good. Amen. I want us to look at Genesis chapter 12. Verse 1, you can do it in your spare times if you'd like. But I'll just read this quickly. The Lord said to Abraham, leave your native land, your relatives, and your father's house, and go to a country that I'm going to show you. Amen? Yeah. People of God, follow this very closely. Verse 2, I will give you many descendants, and they will become a great nation. I will bless you and make your name famous so that you will be a blessing. Praise God. How, what happened with Abraham? The Lord spoke it, and he went forth. He listened. If Abraham did not listen, how would he receive the deep? How would he become the father of many nations? And God is saying to each and every one of us in this house, you are here, it's for you. It's time for the deep to be explored. What is hindering my deeper? What is hindering me from getting to the deeper things of God? You see what happened? It's not what I expect. It's not how I expect it to be. It's not what I'm saying. It's not what I'm thinking, but it's what God is saying. 1 Corinthians 2, verse 9. Go ahead. Praise God.
But as it is written, I have not seen, nor ear heard, neither have it entered into the heart of man, the things which God hath prepared for them that love him.
Praise God. Why? What are you thinking? Why she just leave her shoes? You're thinking, why did she just drop the tissue, the toilet paper on the floor? Bless you for taking it up. It's empty. Pastor Mike said earlier, there's water. What is she going to do with this? Doesn't make sense. And I'm very nosy, so I'll ask individual who I'm comfortable with, what were you thinking? What the Lord is saying to us, it's not going to make sense to you, Pastor Phil. But I, God, tell her to do this. What will happen if I do it? God will be glorified. Now I'm tapping in the deeper. Because the deeper is leaving the shoes to bring a point. It doesn't make sense to you because it looked messy. But what is mess to me and you is God's purpose must be fulfilled. What God is saying, it's not time for us to criticizing, it's not time for us to watching what is not our business. It's time to receive the deeper. Praise God. The Ebola is a problem, and as the man of God said, we should have no fear. But what is happening? The church is having fear like the unsaved, the people who don't know who he is, because we are missing the deeper. The deeper is what is going to, when it births, it's inside. When it let loose, woman of God, we can help the world who is confused. Because what? Verse 9 says, man, we don't know the mind of God. So how are we going to help? How are we going to receive the deeper if we are not positioning for it to be?
Amen. Amen.
It's not time for us to be over here is Savior's Place Church. Over here is New Beginning. Over here is New Image. It's time for the oneness. And the Lord wants me to tell New Image family, whatever what your pastors are doing is the deeper exploding for the unity of the body, the oneness. You talk about the where the trees are and the different changes, different season. My God, that's the word of God. As long as we come together, follow your pastor, it's going to look crazy, like the toilet paper. But God is giving them the deeper so they can go overflow and you can receive. For we need it in this time. It's not the time for us to be wondering. It's the time for us to be receiving. It's not the time for us to talk about the enemy is doing this. Right. Satan made me do this. What Satan? Right. The deeper is on the inside.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
The all power is on the inside. Please. Satan can touch that.
Amen.
He cannot. He's not a match to the Almighty God. God created him. So let's not focus on what the enemy is doing, but let's focus on receiving the deeper.
Yes, Lord.
That has not yet been revealed unto us, but let it be revealed this day. Because now we're going to focus that I already have the Holy Spirit. The Holy God, the Spirit is on the inside. So if His Spirit is already inside, I have to do, you have to do, is let your Spirit come in line with his spirit, so both spirit come together, explode, and then we operate in the deeper. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Remember Genesis. Don't forget it. What Noah, what Abraham did. Now I could use some help. Kidding. Oh, praise God. Amen. What is God telling? And this is personal. What is God telling you to do that you're struggling with it? What is he saying? It's not making any sense, but he's saying it. Stop resisting the Holy Spirit and do his will. If Abraham did not move, he would not have received. If we don't move when God speaks, we won't receive. If you move on your time, you're going to miss his timing. Because today, I had to be here this morning at the right time to receive my T-shirt. Praise God. I had to be here at the right time, and I'm looking for the young lady I met in the ladies' room. Here she goes. To meet this lady, we went in at the right time. Please, could you just stand, please? Why did I have to make a knot? She wanted one like mine. It seems it wasn't making sense to whoever in the bathroom. Did it make sense to you? Mm. But the Lord said to me, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. She catch it. She wants to. She didn't hesitate. She comes forward. Because God had to use, there is always a lamb in the bush. But we miss it because we are like, that don't make sense. But we have to go deep so it can explode. How can it explode if I keep missing it? Ephesians, God bless you. The Lord is talking to us. Amen. We don't know each other. We've seen each other. And when you went into Ephesians chapter 1, I said, yes, Lord, I'm going to do what you say. Confirmation. He wants us to have his deeper. I think you read at verse 1 and 2. But I'm going to take you to 17. Praise God. And this is for each person in this building. This is what the Lord is saying. Hallelujah. And I'm using the Good News Bible. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 17. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. In the knowledge of him. Whose knowledge do we need? Who is going to take us to the deeper? Who does it make sense to? Verse 18. The eyes of your understanding enlighten that the hope of his calling and that the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Stand with me, please. Glory to God. Hallelujah. As we touch touch somebody just in connection. Just hold somebody's hand. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Father God, we thank you. Father God, we bless you. Father God, we thank you for the anointing. Father God, we thank you for the deeper. Lord, we thank you for the mighty revelation, God, that your word says, Father God, you will pour out, hallelujah, you will pour out this day, God, oh, hallelujah, a new anointing in this house, that every person, my God, will not leave the same, but they will leave with a deeper understanding of who you are, God Almighty. That they will leave this place, God, oh, glory to God, experiencing the supernatural, Almighty God. Father God, as you reign and pour out your Shekinah glory in this house, Lord, we just want to say we thank you. Lord, we bless you for your awesomeness. We thank you, my God, that we will do your will. Father God, wherever you lead us, we will follow. We'll follow you all the way, Jesus. Oh, Almighty God, we come this day, Lord, commit ourselves unto you, God, that we shall give ourselves away unto you to holiness, to righteousness, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, Lord, we receive your abundant blessing as you continue, my God, to fill us up with your glory. With your glory, with your glory, in Jesus' name. So let it be. So let it be. Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'm almost speechless. I've been so blessed today by these two men of God and this woman of God. Amen. Just pray that this enters in, as brother said earlier, just that God speaks what he needs to speak to each of us individually. Amen. And his sister said, to receive, to go deeper. So I just pray that you reflect as we sing this song. Let it be a blessing.
Fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song. Song itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. Coming back to heart of worship. So sorry, Lord, thing I made when it's all around you, it's all around you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak, though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours. Every single breath, I'll bring you more. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required.
You search much deeper within.
You search much deeper within.
Through the way
things appear,
you're looking into my heart.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it. And it's all about you. It's all about you.
I'm coming back.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's all about you.
Yes.
It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made,
Lord.
When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus.
When it's all about you,
it's all about you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Keith, there we go. Praise God. I love that song. I love that song. Amen. You know, I love what my brother said. We can't possibly capture all of that. It's hard enough with one, but the three? Come on now. That's impossible. That's just so impossible. But what happens? Simple. I'm just changed, man. I'm not worrying about tomorrow. I'm not worrying about the barbecue. I'm just in the moment. I just get to hear from God. I'm just in the moment. Dr. Randy, I saw a giant up here, man. I don't know what you ate. I don't know what they gave you. I mean, Goliath had a pretty hefty diet. He had to be. He was 9 feet. But who is the real giant now? Come on. Who was the real giant? Dr. Randy was the real giant. You had the right diet. You took Goliath down. Amen? Yeah. Pastor Outlaw. Oh, thank God for Pastor Outlaw. You know what Pastor Outlaw did for me? He outlawed the fault finder. Come on. He said, Phil, you want to go deeper? I said, yeah, I want to go deeper. You got to outlaw the fault finder. I said, oh, my goodness. You mean that was a message for me? Lord, that was an internal message for me? Oh, thank God for Pastor Outlaw. I like having a Pastor Outlaw. Woo! That even sounds powerful. Yeah, there's no fault finder. I don't know what you're talking about. I see Christ. I see the love of God. I see unsearchable riches. Now, Pastor Williams, my brother and I, we were having some discussion over there. Now, Michael said, what are you doing making a mess up here? And I said, whoa, wait a second. No. Moses took off his shoes for the burning bush. You were the burning bush. You know what I also saw? Bible says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. The Spirit of the Lord was in my Pastor Williams this morning, and she had the freedom to take off her shoes, to sing, to dance, to do whatever it is. Why? Because God told her to. And then I can't tell you how many mornings I'll sit there at my computer reading
with my coffee and I say, Lord, it don't make sense. I said, Lord, it don't make sense. I can't even tell you how many times I speak those words. And what does she do when she gets up here? It don't make sense. What made sense was the love of my sister, though. The love of my brother, the love of my brother. It all made sense and it all came together and it was just, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Mike, now I'm going to be honest. Mike and I said, man, we can't wait for Saturday. You know why? Because we just get to chill and you guys do it. And we did. Bless God, we did. Amen. But even as you were up here, I actually got to speak with our Pastor Randy briefly this morning. And talking to him, and I said, okay, probably from someplace else. So where are you from? He said, Kentucky. I said, oh, man. I said, I used to live in Nashville. I used to run part of our business was up in Kentucky, and we used to go down into the holler. He said, you mean the holler? I said, oh, yeah, the holler. But one of the other trips I actually made in Kentucky, which Kentucky is also known for, and I thought of this story when the three of you were preaching, was the caverns in Kentucky. And literally, you will find like a hole in the ground, and you can actually go into it, and they're actually caves. And Kentucky is well known for these. Well, this one particular time, my company was doing like this team building event where you try and be nice with one another and don't find fault and figure out how you're going to work nice together. But you go on this kind of adventure. And one at this particular time, we were split up into teams. There was four of us. And you had to go into this cavern. Now, when I tell you, it's literally like you just go out and find a hole in the ground and you go down and it's literally caves. But can you imagine? There's no electricity running down there, right? You know what I'm talking about? I mean, it's just pitch black. And so they give you a miner's hat, literally a miner's hat with a light on it, because otherwise you cannot see anything. And there were five hidden clues. There were red reflective capsules and there was clues. And you need those clues to complete this event. So the four of us climb into this hole. Now, can I tell you, it was just like, Lord, I know you got to be with me because I got to go through this hole and I don't know what's on the other side of this hole, but we had to go deeper. And bless God, the four of us go into this hole. And sure enough, we're going through the caverns and it's pitch black and it's rock. And there was a couple of places where there's like running water and it was really cool. But anyway, we find four of the clues. We find the four capsules. We see the last capsule, it's the fifth capsule. And it wasn't easy to get to all of them, as you might imagine, because again, it's just a natural cave in the ground. Well, this last one was buried. And you could see it, when you had the light on it, it reflected. But when we went to reach, you couldn't reach it. And then if you tried to go down, you had to take off your helmet because your head, the crevice was so narrow, you couldn't even fit your head through there with the helmet on. Now, they said in the beginning of this thing, you can get to them. You can get to every one of them. And so where we finally landed was I took off my helmet. And two of the men that I was with, one grabbed one foot and one grabbed the other foot and lowered me down. But that wasn't good enough. There was also a woman with me. Her name was Darlene. Because I didn't have a helmet, so I could not see. And so she had to shine the light on the reflective piece. Now, the only way I could get deeper was with Pastor Randy, Pastor Outlaw, and Pastor William. Sometimes we need one another to get deeper. And you do, bless God. But you can go places that you've never been before. You can go places you've never been before. You just gotta be in the moment. You just gotta listen. Will somebody listen? Bless God for the words this morning. Amen. You truly blessed us all. Amen. Truly blessed us all. So this afternoon, we've got quite a bit of stuff planned outside. So we'll do a little housekeeping. But we're going to have our barbecue outside. And, bless God, we just want to enjoy the day and have a great time out there. So in a second, I'm going to also bless it. So once we go out there, we can just kind of enjoy the event. After lunch, we then have our master of ceremonies, my brother Rich Porzio. If you were here last year, listen, you know, my brother and I, we bring up forth the word, but my brother Rich will have you in tears laughing. So he's going to be hosting the event this afternoon, and I know he's got a number of things planned. We have the worship team. They've got songs playing. We're going to have like a little concert out there. Just enjoy. Let our hair down a little bit. Well, some of you, not Brother Outlaw and I. We can't do that. But you know. But anyway, we're just going to enjoy the day out there, enjoy fellowship, have a great time. There's really, we're not in a rush for anything. It's just enjoy the day, enjoy time with each other, hopefully get to know each other a little bit better. But my brother will be hosting that, and so we hopefully you'll be here and enjoy, and hopefully others will come and just have lunch and just relax. So we just want to enjoy the day with one another, if that's all right, amen? Why don't you stand? We'll just close out with a word of prayer, amen? Heavenly Father, what can we say, Lord? We are truly amazed this morning, Lord God, at the depths that you've taken us to again, Lord God, that there's something greater, Lord. There's something greater inside of each and every one of us. And so we thank you for our Dr. Randy and for our Pastor Outlaw and for our Pastor Williams who took us a little deeper, Lord, and gave us a little bit more of you, Lord God, a little bit more of love, Lord God, and kindness. And Lord, what can we say? We are truly amazed, Lord, by all your goodness this day, Lord God, in the house and all that are here, Lord. We thank you for the time just to worship, Lord, and just to recognize your goodness, Lord, and just all that you are doing, Lord. And you just continue to reveal yourself each and every day, Lord. It's just truly amazing, Lord. We're truly, truly amazed by it all, Lord. Lord, we thank you for all that have participated and helped. We know, Lord, there's just so many folks and so many hands that go into this, Lord. But we know, Lord, that we are the hands and feet of Christ. So we thank you, Lord, that it's all done in the name of your Son, Lord Jesus Christ, Lord. And so we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the day and for all that unfolds, Lord, for this wonderful time that you prepared, for this lunch, Lord, and for all that are out there that will serve, Lord God. We just thank you for it all and bless your name. And everybody said,
amen. Amen. Amen.
We need to take the stands because we might do something out of this stuff.